Good morning everyone. Today I'm here with my next video on the chapter The Shepherd's Daughter by William Saroyan. In this video, I will tell you the summary of the story along with the theme, followed by question answers and reference to context of this chapter. For better explanation, please see the live session which I have already taken on this chapter. Let us see the summary of the story. The narrator's grandmother believes that every young man should know an honorable craft. When the narrator says that he does not know how to make a useful item, his grandmother narrates the story of a king whose son fell in love with a shepherd's daughter. When the prince shared this with his father, he sent word to the shepherd's daughter. She in return put forth a condition that she would marry the prince only if he learned some craft. So the prince learned to weave rugs, and soon the prince and the shepherd's daughter were married. One day, while walking down the streets of Baghdad, the prince was captured by some thieves. The prince told the thieves that he was the son of a weaver and could weave beautiful rugs which would fetch them good money from the king. He wove 3 rugs in 3 days, and the thieves took them to the king. The king took the rugs to the shepherd's daughter, and she read the hidden message woven in the rugs by her husband. The thieves were caught, and the prince and the other captives were released. Having understood the importance of being skilled, the narrator too decided to learn some carpentry. The theme of the story is that there is no limit to learning. Knowledge is bound to hold you in good stead at some stage in your life. So we should all learn at least some honorable craft which might be useful for us sometime in future. Let us start with the question and answers. Question 1. What did grandmother ask the writer? The answer is, the grandmother asked the writer if he could make anything like a simple table, a chair, a plain dish, or a coffee pot. Question 2. What did the shepherd's daughter want the king's son to do? Answer is, the shepherd's daughter wanted the king's son to learn some honorable craft. Question 3. When did the girl agree to marry the prince? The answer is, the girl agreed to marry the prince at the end of 3 days when he learned to make straw rugs in different pattern, colors and designs. Here we have some pictures. We can see the king of Persia with his son on the top. We can see a picture of a rug, although this is not a straw rug, but it is a beautiful rug. In the similar manner, straw rugs are made. And here we see the prince and his wife, the shepherd's daughter, when they got married. Let us see the fourth question. How was the prince taken captive? The answer is, the prince was taken captive when he entered an eating place in Baghdad, which looked very comfortable. But the place was full of thieves and murderers. They made the prince a captive and placed him in a large dungeon. The prince saw many great men of his city there. The murderers were killing the fattest men and were feeding them to the leanest. And we can see on the top, there is this comfortable place where the prince entered and was caught by the murderers and the thieves. And here at the bottom, we can see a dungeon where he was made captive. Question 5. How did the rugs save the prince's life? The rugs helped the prince prove to the thieves and murderers that he was indeed a weaver. When his woven rugs were taken to the king, he recognized that they were made by his lost son. The prince's wife detected the secret message that were woven by the prince in the rugs in Persian language. Following those messages, the king's soldiers caught the thieves and the murderers and rescued the prince and the other captives. That was how the rugs saved the prince's life. Question 6. What did the writer decide to do after listening to the story? After listening to the story, the writer decided that as soon as he earned enough money to buy a saw, a hammer, and a piece of lumber, he would do his best to make a simple chair or a shelf for books. Let us now see reference to context. The first extract is as follows. You must learn to do some good work, the making of some item useful to man, something out of clay or out of wood or metal or cloth. The question is, who said these words? The answer is, the writer's grandmother said these words. Next question, to whom did the speaker say these words? The writer's grandmother said these words to the writer. The writer here is William Saroyan. C part, what message did the speaker want to convey? The writer's grandmother wanted to convey the message that everyone should learn a useful craft, for one never knew when it could prove to be useful in life. Let us see the second extract. Why? He is the son of the king. He does no labor. A part, who said these words to whom? The answer is, the king's messenger said these words to the shepherd's daughter. Question B, why did the speaker say these words? The answer is, the messenger said these words because the shepherd's daughter had asked him, what labor did the king's son do? C part, what did the speaker do after these words were spoken? Answer C is, after these words were spoken, the king's messenger returned to the king and told him what the shepherd's daughter had said. Let us see the fourth question. How was the prince taken captive? The answer is, the prince was taken captive when he entered an eating place in Baghdad which looked very comfortable. But the place was full of thieves and murderers. They made the prince a captive and placed him in a large dungeon. The prince saw many great men of his city there. The murderers were killing the fattest men and were feeding them to the leanest. And we can see on the top there is this comfortable place where the prince entered and was caught by the murderers and the thieves. And here at the bottom, we can see a dungeon where he was made captive. So these were the question and answers and the reference to context questions. I also have a live session of this, which has already been published and it is there in the channel. Please go through that for better understanding. For any more queries, please put them in the comment section. If you have still not subscribed my channel, please do press the subscribe button and also the bell icon for the latest notifications. Do take good care of yourself and do please learn some honorable craft. Goodbye.